everyone, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Ashim Datta and today we are going to discuss about discrete component trainer and its order code is 36185A. So in this video we are going to discuss about its body parts and its working. Now let's talk about the body parts of this kit. So this is the DC supply of 0 to 15 volt positive, then this is the negative 0 to 15 volt supply, and we can vary these voltage from 0 to 15 by using these ports. Then this is the fixed DC supply of plus 12 volt, minus 12 volt and plus 5 volt. Then this is the AC supply of 9 volt, then this is the main on off button, then this is the audio output transmitter, then these are the potentiometers of 1K, 10K and 100K, then this is the relay, then this is the Vero board, then these are the diodes, then this is photodiode, then these are the Zener diode, then these are the LEDs, these are coils, this is speaker, then these are the capacitors, then these are the resistors, then these are the transistors, then this is FET, this is UJT, this is MOSFET, this is SCR, this is TRIAC, this is DIAC and this is LDR. So this is the body parts of this kit. Now let's see how this kit works. So for that we are going to perform an experiment, that is verification of Ohm's law. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the supply, the positive terminal of the supply, with the 1K resistor. Then we will connect the multimeter. So we have to take the multimeter and set it on milliampere range so that we can measure the current. So we have to connect the positive terminal of the multimeter with the other end of the resistor. Like this. Then we have to connect the negative terminal of the multimeter with the negative terminal of the supply, like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we have to give plus 5 volt supply to this resistance. So we will use this multimeter to check the plus 5 volt supply. So we will connect the positive terminal to the positive one and the negative terminal to the negative one. And we have to see the current reading. So now I am switching on the kit. Then we will give plus 5 volt supply. So by rotating this port you can adjust the 5 volt supply. So here on the multimeter you can see that the current reading is also showing on the multimeter. So I have given 5 volt supply to this resistance and you can see the current on this multimeter. Now we will check the resistance for 470 ohm. So we will change the resistance to 470 ohm and then we will measure the current again. So here you can see that the current reading is 9.4 and earlier at 1K it is 4.8. So you can conclude that when we reduce the resistance the current increases and when we increase the resistance the current decreases. So that's follow the Ohm's law. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is verification of Kirchhoff's current law. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the positive terminal of the supply with the 470 ohm terminal like this. Then we will connect The other terminal of 470 ohm resistance with the 1k resistance like this. Then we will connect the 470 ohm resistance port with the 3k3 resistance port like this. Then we will again connect the 470 ohm port resistance with the 4k7 resistance like this. Then we have to ground all these three resistors, 1k, 3k3 and 4k7. So we will ground it to this supply negative terminal like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the main gate and we have to give 10 volt supply to all these resistance. So for that we will connect this multimeter and we will vary the port and set it at 10 volt. So here on the multimeter you can see that we have given 10 volt supply to all these resistance. Now we will measure the current along 1k, 3k3 and 4k7 resistance. So we will connect the positive terminal of the multimeter to the 470 ohm resistance like this, and we will remove one by one wire from all these resistance and we will measure the current. So here on the 1k resistance we can see that the current reading is 5.7 milliampere. Then we will measure the current for resistance 3k3. So we will make the connection like this. So here you can see that it is around 1.7. Then we will again connect this wire to the 3K3 port. Now we will remove the wire of 4K7 and we will connect the negative port of the multimeter to this 3K7 port. So here on the multimeter you can see that the current reading is 1.2 milliampere. So that's the alternate current reading of all these three resistance. Now we will measure the current along 470 ohm. So we will remove this supply wire and we will connect the positive terminal of the multimeter here and the negative terminal here. So here you can see that the current along 470 ohm is 8.6 milliampere. So the 8.5 milliampere current is divided into 1k, 3k3 and 4k7. So when we add the current of 1k ohm and 3k3 ohm and 4k7 ohm, it will togetherly give 8.5 milliampere. That is the 470 ohm current. So that follows the Kirchhoff's law current, that from this resistance the current gets divided into these three resistance, and when we add the current of these three resistance it will be equal to the current of this 470 ohm resistance. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study the diode characteristics. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the positive terminal of the supply to the 1k resistance like this. Then we will connect the other end of the 1k resistance with the positive terminal of the ammeter, or we can say multimeter, like this. Then we will connect the negative terminal of the multimeter with the diode 1N66. Like this. And the other end of the diode is connected to the ground terminal of the supply, like this. Then we have to measure the voltage at the diode. So for that we have to take another multimeter . So that is how the connection is done. Now we will perform the experiment. So we will switch on the kit and we have to give voltage to the diode. So for that we will connect this multimeter to read the supply voltage. So we will connect the positive terminal with the positive one and the negative terminal with the negative one. Now we will increase the voltage by 0.1 volt step. So we will give 0.1 voltage like this. So here on the multimeter you can see that the supply voltage is 0.1. And here on the multimeter you can see the current and you can see the diode voltage by using this voltmeter. We will connect the negative terminal with the diode ground terminal and we will connect the positive terminal with the other end of the diode, like this. So here on the multimeter you can see that the diode voltage and diode current is this. So the current is 0.04 milliampere and the diode voltage is 0.1 volt when we apply 0.1 volt at the supply end. Now we will give 0.2 volt. So at 0.2 volt you can see that the current is 0.08 milliampere and the voltage is 0.14. Now we will give 0.3 volt at the supply. So now you can see that the current is 0.16 and the voltage is 0.17. So that is how you can take the readings and form a table and you can draw the graph of diode also. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study Zener diode characteristics. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the positive terminal of the supply with the 47 ohm resistance, like this. Then we will connect the other end of the 47 ohm resistance with the negative end of the multimeter, like this. Then we will connect the Zener diode 9.1 volt . So we will connect the positive terminal of the multimeter with the Zener diode port, like this. And the other end of the Zener diode is connected to the ground terminal of the supply, like this. And here we have to measure the Zener voltage also. So for that we need this multimeter. It will read the Zener diode voltage and this multimeter will read the current of Zener diode. Now we will switch on the kit and we will connect this Zener diode voltage to this end for calculating the Zener diode voltage, and we have to apply supply voltage. So for that we have to connect this multimeter to read the supply voltage, and we have to vary the supply voltage in 1 volt step. So now we will give 1 volt at the supply like this. So here you can see that on the multimeter it is 1 volt, and now we will measure the Zener diode voltage. So here on the multimeter you can see that the Zener diode voltage is almost same as the supplied voltage, but it is in negative direction. Now we will increase the supply voltage to 2 volt. So here you can see that on the Zener diode it is minus 2.1 volt. Now we will increase the voltage to 3 volt. So here on the Zener diode the voltage is minus 3.19 volt. So it is almost same as the supply voltage, but this Zener diode voltage is in negative volt. Now we will increase it to 4 volt like this. Then we will increase it to 5 volt. Then we will increase it to 6 volt. So here on the multimeter you can see that there is no change, as we have applied now 8 volt at the supply, still there is no change at the multimeter, and this Zener voltage is almost same as the supply voltage. And now we have given 9 volt at the supply. So here you can see that on the multimeter there is a minute change in the current, and when we increase this 9 volt to 10 volt, so here you can see that on the multimeter the Zener current is suddenly increased and it is minus 6.5 milliampere. So that is the Zener diode current and that is the Zener diode voltage. So you can form an observation table and you can plot the graph between this Zener diode current and Zener diode voltage. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study the basic gates using diodes and transistor. So we will study the NOT gate. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the positive terminal of the supply with the 470 ohm resistance like this. Then we will connect the other terminal of the 470 ohm resistance with the transistor BC547 Now we will connect the emitter end of the BC547 with the ground one. Like this. Then we will connect the other end of the transistor with the 1K resistance. Like this. Then we will connect the other end of the 1K resistance with the 5 volt supply. Like this. Then we will connect the ground terminal of the 5 volt supply with the ground terminal of the main supply. Like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the main kit, and now we will measure the voltage through this multimeter and we will see the supply voltage by using this multimeter. So we connect the positive terminal with the positive one and the negative terminal with the negative one. So firstly we will give 0 volt at the supply. So here you can see that the supply is currently 0 volt. So at 0 volt we will measure the voltage at the capacitor and the ground of the supply. So at the collector you can see that when we apply 0 volt at the supply, then at the collector we get 5 volt, and when we give 5 volt at the supply, by wearing this port you can increase the supply voltage like this. So currently the supply voltage is 5 volt. Now we will measure the voltage at the collector end. So here on the collector end you can see that now the voltage is 0 volt. So that is how the experiment is performed. So this shows the property of NOT gate. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study UJT. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the B1 terminal of the UJT with the 470 ohm resistance like this. Then we will connect the other end of the 470 ohm resistance with the ground terminal of plus 12 volt like this. Then we will connect the B2 terminal of the UJT with the 1k resistance like this. Then the other end of the 1k resistance is connected to the 220k resistance like this. Then we will connect the 220k resistance with the emitter of the UJT like this. Then we will connect the emitter with the 100k PF capacitor like this. And the other end of the 100k PF capacitor is connected to the ground terminal of the 12 volt fixed DC supply like this. And the other end of the 1k resistance is connected to the plus 12 volt supply like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will take one patch code from emitter end and one patch code from the ground terminal of the 12 volt DC supply, and we will connect both the terminals with the DSO probe. So the ground terminal is connected to the ground terminal of the DSO probe and the emitter terminal is connected to the positive terminal of the DSO probe like this. Now we will switch on the DSO and we will switch on the kit. So here on the DSO you can see that the UJT waveform at the emitter end is like this. Now we can see the waveform at the B1 and B2 end. So just change the position of this emitter patch code to the first B2, and here you can see that the waveform of B2 is like this. So at the B2 end we get negative side waveform like this. Now we can see the waveform at the B1 end. So just change the port to the B1 end, and here you can see that at B1 we get the waveform at positive end like this. So that is how you can perform this experiment. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study SCR characteristics. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the supply voltage with the 10k resistance like this. Then we will connect the other end of the 10k resistance with the positive terminal of the multimeter like this. Then we will connect the resistance 1k with the gate terminal of the SCR like this. Then we will connect the other end of the 1k resistance with the ground terminal of the supply like this. Then we will connect the cathode terminal of the SCR with the ground terminal of the supply like this. Then we will connect the anode of the SCR with the negative terminal of the multimeter like this. Then we will connect the positive terminal of the multimeter with the 1k resistance like this. Then we will connect the other end of the 1k resistance with the negative terminal of this supply. This supply is negative 0 to 15 volt, but here I am using it for positive, so I have changed the polarity. You can do the connections for this potentiometer, but here I am connecting this to this variable supply and I have just changed the polarity. Now I'll connect the positive terminal with the ground terminal of the supply. Now the negative terminal of the multimeter is connected to the gate terminal of the SCR like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the main gate, and now we will give VAK as 5 volt. VAK is the anode to cathode voltage. So this is the VAK voltage, and we can measure the gate voltage by using this multimeter. So this is the gate voltage, and we can measure the IAK current, that is anode to cathode current, by using this multimeter, and we can measure the gate current by using this multimeter. So firstly we will give VAK as 5 volt. So we will connect the negative port with this terminal, and we will connect the positive port with this terminal. So this is the VAK. You can increase the voltage by varying this port. So we have to keep it at 5 volt. So I am keeping this VAK at 5 volt. Like this. So here on the multimeter you can see that the VAK voltage is at 5 volt. Now we will vary the VG by 0.5 steps. Now we will keep VG at 0.5. So at 0.5 you can see that the gate current is 0.049 milliampere and the IAK current is 0. Now we will increase this gate voltage and we will keep it at 1 volt. So here at 1 volt you can see that the gate current is 0.09 milliampere and the IAK current is still 0. Now I am increasing the gate voltage and here I am keeping it at 2 volt. Here still the IAK is 0. That means that the SCR is not fired. So we have to fire the SCR for conducting. So I am increasing the supply voltage and now at 5 volt you can see that the IAK is showing some current. So when we increase this voltage we can see that the IAK current is 0.03 milliampere and now we will again increase this voltage and here at 6.51 volt you can see that the IAK current is 3.8 milliampere. That means that the SCR is conducted and it gets fired. Now you can reduce this gate voltage to 0. You can see that still the SCR is conducting. So you can see this property on the LED also. So just change the port of this 1K resistance to the LED. So now when we again give this LED the voltage, so when the SCR gets fired you can see that the LED is glowing. So this shows that the SCR is conducting. You can check it for this LED also. Just change the port to this LED and you can see that now this LED blinks. So this shows the property of SCR and that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study tri characteristics. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the positive terminal of the supply with the 470 ohm resistance like this. Then we will connect the other end of the 470 ohm resistance with the positive terminal of the multimeter like this. Then we will connect the negative terminal of the multimeter with the MT2 port of the triac. Like this. Then we will connect the MT1 port of the triac with the negative port of the supply. Like this. Then we will connect the gate of the triac with the negative terminal of the multimeter. Like this. Then we will connect the positive terminal of the multimeter with the 1K resistance like this. Then we will connect the 1K resistance other end with the supply port this. Here I am using this port as the VG supply. You can use any of these potentiometer, you can do the connections according to that and the connection is mentioned in the manual. But here I am just changing the polarity so that I can use this port as 0 to 12 volt DC supply for VG calculation. So now we will connect the positive terminal with the ground terminal of the main supply. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the main kit and we will connect this multimeter to the VAA port. So we have to keep VAA at 2 volt. So this is the VAA. We will connect the positive with the positive port and the negative with the negative port. So this is the VAA port. We have to keep this at 2 volt. So set this at 2 volt by using this port. So here on the multimeter you can see that I have set this VAA at 2 volt. Now we will vary the VG. So now we will connect this multimeter to this port, that is VG port, and now we will vary the VG and we will see the IG current on this multimeter and IL current on this multimeter. So this multimeter will show gate current and this multimeter will show load current, and this is the gate voltage we are going to vary. We have kept VAA voltage as 2 volt constant. Now we will vary the VG voltage by 1 volt step. So let's set it at 1 volt. So here you can see that I have set this VG at 1 volt and you can see the IG current as 0.856 milliampere. Now we will again vary this VG voltage to 2 volt. So now you can see that when we kept this at 2 volt, the IG current is 1.6 milliampere. Now we will again keep it at 3 volt. And again you can see that the gate current becomes 2.5 milliampere. So here you can see that the IL current is still zero. That means the triac is not conducting yet. So we have to increase this voltage to make the triac conducting. So I am increasing this voltage. So here you can see that after we increase the voltage to 5 volt, the triac starts conducting and you can see that the IL current is 0.07 milliampere and the IG current is 4.1 milliampere. Now we will set this voltage as at 6 volt. So now you can see that the IL current becomes 2.08 milliampere and the gate current becomes 5.0 milliampere. So that is how you can take readings till 10 volt. So again increase this voltage to 7 volt. So here you can see that at 7 volt the IG current becomes 5.9 milliampere and the IL current becomes 2.12 milliampere. So that is how you can take the readings and you can plot the graph between VG and IL. So that is how this experiment is performed. So similarly you can take the readings of negative gate voltage and negative gate current and negative load current. So the connections will be remain same, just we have to change the ports connection like this. The supply connection negative port will be shifted to the positive port and the other supply port will be shifted to the other port supply like this. Just we have to switch the connections of both of these ports. Now we will again do the same procedure. We will keep the VAA as -2 volt now, because we are doing it for negative. So we will keep VAA at -2 volt. So we will keep VAA as -2 volt. So here on the multimeter you can see that the VAA is -2 volt. Now we will vary the gate voltage at -1 volt step. So now I am keeping it at -1 volt. So here you can see that the IG current becomes 0.86 milliampere, and it is of negative sign. Now we will again vary this voltage to -2 volt. Now you can see that the gate current is -1.5 milliampere. So similarly you have to increase this gate voltage, and you have to note down the IG current and IL current. So again, IL current is not showing any value, it is 0. So that means the track is still not conducting. So after keeping the voltage at -5 volt, you can see that the IL current becomes 0.2 milliampere in negative, and the IG current becomes -4.0 milliampere. So that is how you can take the connections and form the graph between VG and IL. So that is how you can do this experiment. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study LED characteristics. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the positive terminal of the supply with the 1k resistance like this. Then we will connect the other end of the 1k resistance with the positive terminal of the multimeter like this. Then we will connect the negative terminal of the multimeter with the one end of the LED like this. Then we will connect the other end of the LED with the ground terminal of the supply voltage like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the main gate, and now we will vary the input voltage, that is VIN. So we will connect this multimeter to get the readings of VIN, and we will connect this multimeter to get the voltage reading of this LED. So we will connect the negative port with this ground port of the LED, and we will connect the positive with the other end of the LED. So now we will vary the input voltage. So we are keeping it at 1 volt. So here you can see that the the LED voltage is 1.16 volt. Now we will vary the voltage. So now the input voltage becomes 2 volt, and now the LED output voltage becomes 1.8, and the LED current becomes 0.14 milliampere. And you can see that the LED starts glowing. Now as you increase the voltage, the intensity of LED light increases. So that is how you can take the readings of voltage and current, and you can plot the graph of voltage and current of the LED. So you can see that as you increase the voltage, the LED voltage and current increases. So that is how this experiment is performed, and you can check it for the other LED also. That is the green one. So just shift the connections to this LED and you can check the voltage and current on this LED also. And you can form the graph of voltage and current of this LED. So that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study LDR characteristics. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the positive port of the supply with the LDR port like this. Then we will connect the other port of the LDR with the positive terminal of the multimeter like this. Then we will connect the negative terminal of the multimeter with the negative terminal of the supply like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the main gate, and now we have to give supply voltage Vin as 5 volt or 10 volt. So right now I am giving 5 volt as Vin. So we are using this multimeter to measure the Vin voltage. So now we will set it at 5 volt. So here on the multimeter you can see that the voltage is set it at 5 volt. Now we will increase the voltage of table lamp. So we have to take the readings at 100 volt, 120 volt, 140 volt, 160 volt and up to 220 volt AC supply. So now we will use this variac, and now we will set the AC voltage of table lamp at 100 volt. So now you can see that the current at LDR is 0.09 milliampere. Now we will give 120 volt. So now you can see that the LDR current is 0.2 milliampere. Now we will set it at 140 volt. So now you can see that the intensity of table lamp increases and the current also increases, and it is at 0.382 milliampere. Now we will set it at 160 volt. So now you can see that the current is at 0.4 milliampere. Now we will set it at 180. So now you can see that the current is 0.5 milliampere. So that is how you can take the readings and you can form the graph between AC voltage of table lamp and current, and you can find the resistance also by using V is equal to IR formula. You are having the voltage and you are getting the current from here. So that is how you can calculate the resistance and you can form the graph of resistance and AC voltage also. So that is how you can perform this experiment. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study FET characteristics and source follower. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the gate of the FET with the 100k resistance like this. Then we will connect the other end of the 100k resistance to the 100k potentiometer like this. Then we will connect the one end of the potentiometer to the negative 12 volt and the other end to the ground like this. Now we will connect the source of the FET to the ground like this. Then we will connect the drain of the FET to the 3K2 resistance like this. Then we will connect the other end of the 3K3 resistance to the negative port of the multimeter like this. Then we will connect the positive port of the multimeter to the 1K port like this. Then we will connect the other port of the 1K potentiometer to the plus 12 volt supply. Then we will connect the ground terminal of the 1K potentiometer port to the ground terminal of plus 12 volt supply. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the main kit and we will take another multimeter for seeing the VGS and VDS voltage. So firstly we have to keep VGS voltage at 0 volt. So we will connect this multimeter to 100K port. This is the VGS port, so we have to keep this at 0. So here on the multimeter you can see that this VGS or this 100K potentiometer port is at 0 volt. So we have set the VGS at 0 volt. Now we have to vary the VDS. Now we have to vary the VDS in step of 2 volt. So we will increase the VDS to 2 volt by using this 1K port. So here on the multimeter you can see that we have kept VDS at 2 volt and you can see that the current is 0.3. This current is the drain current. Now we will increase the VDS and we have to increase it in 2 volt step. So we will set it at 4 volt now. And here you can see that the drain current ID is 0.9. So that is how you can take the readings. You have to increase the VDS in steps of 2 volt and you can read the drain current from this multimeter. And you can again change the VGS to minus 1 volt, minus 2 volt and minus 1.5 volt, and you can take the readings according to that. So that is how you can perform this experiment and you can form the graph between VDS and IDS keeping VGS constant. So that is how this experiment is performed. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact at Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.